Hello, this is Dr. Kosmali from Prague. On my chapter on life cycle strategy plan for Vyvanse, first chapter is called the market, and we'll go through medical unmet need product addresses. Some facts about attention deficit disorder. It's one of the most neurobehavioral disorders of childhood. It is usually first diagnosed in childhood and often last into adulthood. We know about three types. First type is predominantly inattentive type, second is predominantly hyperactive impulsive type, and third type is a combination of these two types. For each of these types, at least six of symptoms should list for at least 6 months. In general, signs and symptoms are that whereas normal children have some problems from time to time with focusing and behaving, children with attention deficit disorder just not grow out of this behavior, and this is causing them problems. For example, paying attention, talking too much, forgetting things, daydreaming a lot, not seeming to listen, interrupting others, and other symptoms. For market opportunity, we can say that dexamphetamine is a psychostimulant prodrug and is a combination of effect of phenethylamine and amphetamine compounds. It is used to treat attention deficit disorder and attention deficit hyperactivity disorder as a part of total treatment, which should include psychological, social, and other treatment. It may be to treat certain sleeping disorders to help stay awake and concentrate. It also may be a part of educational, vocational placement and other behavioral therapy, but may not be indicated for example, psychiatric disorders, including psychosis. For benchmarking analysis, we can see that Vyvanse is aimed at three categories of customers: kids, teens, and adults. And there has been already done some studies on comparison to other drugs, medications on the market. For example, Concerta, Strattera. The studies have been done in sites across Europe and US. The competitive landscape for these medications is stimulation use. For attention deficit disorder treatment, it is causing a calming effect. But this medication do not cure attention deficit disorder. They help control the symptoms, they help concentrate. You can see the list of medications beginning with Adderall, Concerta, Daytrena, and ending with Methylene, Ritalin, Strattera. The competitive landscape is also the further research and expansion of knowledge in genetics, brain imaging, and behavioral research to understand the treatment and the cause of ADHD. There has been done some research on dosage of medications. For example, the dosage of stimulant methylphenidate within preschoolers. The results are that children are more sensitive to the side effects of the medication. There are also other research activities, and results may help scientists link variations in genes to difference in how people respond to medications or look for the biological basis of attention deficit disorder. Competitive landscape is also including coexisting psychopathologies such as oppositional defiant disorder and conduct disorder. The list of these coexisting pathologies begins with mood disorders, anxiety disorders, goes through substance disorders, impulse controls disorders, attention deficit and disruptive behavior disorders, developmental disorders, and ends with autism and spectrum disorders. There has been done some investigation of dopamine, norepinephrine modulation in major depressive disorder, excessive daytime sleepiness, negative symptoms in schizophrenia and binge eating disorder. Burden of disease of attention deficit disorder is hard to tell because of global at or European level data can vary up to ethnic or cultural differences, methodology. For example, ADHD is diagnosed within children, children at school age because of their performance, and this can vary up to a certain school system. Worldwide, the prevalence is at 5.29% within preschool children, varies from 2 to 6% within adolescents, from 6 to 7% within adults to 2 to 5%. Another problem is that the rate of diagnosis or that rate of reports is growing and varies, for example, from state to state, or varies between years. It has grown from 2003 to 2007 by 22%, and by 2007 is on 9.5%. Another problem is that the prevalence of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder in adults appears to be approximately equal in males and females, but within females there are differences in childhood and adulthood prevalence, and this may point to that it is being under-identified in girls or show that their symptoms are different from those in boys. Thank you for your attention for this chapter, and see you.